Hello, I am Marcy. I'm back to present part 3 of the demonstration video I call The Big Gestalt. In part 1, I outlined a simple experiment whereby we will record EEG signals from Mark while presenting a flash of light. In part 2, I began work on implementing this experiment within the Synapse software. In this final part 3, I will complete implementation of our experiment and give a preview of the amazing runtime interface of Synapse. Continuing where part 2 left off, our pending task was to reconnect the trigger control input of the artifact reject gizmo to meet the needs of our experiment. Recall that the artifact blocking gizmo is to be controlled by a photodetector that will signal the system whenever the stimulus light flashes. Let's assume that the photodetector emits a logic signal to indicate the flash of light. This logic signal can be connected to any appropriate BNC on the front panel of the RZ device. For this demonstration, we will use bit 0 of port C. You should review the hardware documentation for your RZ device to select an appropriate logic signal input. Before we get started, let's resize the connections diagram and reposition it so we can reference it when needed. Before we can use a signal input from the front panel, we must first configure it using the options dialog for the RZ device. Click on the RZ device in the processing tree and select the Digital I/O tab in the options dialog. Under this tab, you will find a settings table. Here we can configure all of the logic inputs and outputs for the RZ device in our system. Your table may look different. I'm using the RZ2 device. For this experiment, we will enable port C as an input. Also, let's rename this port to something more descriptive. Uncheck the auto ID box and type in the ID name. You will see why this renaming is handy in just a moment. Click commit to save these changes to your experiment. Looking at the connections diagram, you'll now see the input signal we just configured. To use this signal, we must select it as the source for the trigger input of the artifact reject gizmo. A handy way to navigate to a particular gizmo in your experiment is to double-click it in the connections diagram. With the artifact blocker dialog shown, we can now select the proper source for the trigger input from the drop-down list and click commit. Now review the connections diagram. Note, the trigger input is now being sourced by the photodetect signal we configured on the RZ device. We need to tweak just a few more options, and then we're done. For now, let's hide the connection select panel. With the connection select panel hidden, you can now see the options available for the artifact reject gizmo. Just to be showing off, I'll make a few adjustments. First, I'll elect of Synapse save a timing signal associated with the open and closed state of the signal gate. Also, I'll adjust the default onset and offset time for the gating relative the rising edge of the photodetector's logic signal. I'll commit these changes, and we're ready to begin recording data. And, without further ado, let's press record and get some wow factor going. This is nearly what you will see when clicking record. To be fair, I have dressed some things up and dragged some windows to my liking. Adjusting layouts is easy with the amazing Synapse runtime interface. Best of all, my layout will be saved automatically. You can see I'm messing about with the various controls. Note the controls included in this runtime window are tied directly to the gizmos of the experiment. I don't want to give too much away, but this stuff is way groovy. Check out the single units coming from our fake brain. This is cool science. It's all here in Synapse, a program built to run your most challenging experiments with just a few mouse clicks. As you might imagine, It's difficult to summarize in just a few words such an amazing demonstration. What started as talk of a wastewater treatment example soon waylaid into the impossible task of collecting neurological signals from my associate Mark's brain. In the end, we've had an introductory demonstration of the amazing powers of synapse, and hopefully assimilated a well-founded understanding of the core concepts within synapse. I'll say goodbye for now, but hope to see you soon in a future demo. So long.